Once upon a time, I used to work in an office. And then COVID hit, and now I spend most of my days in front of two laptops, a cell phone, an improvised key light, just in order to get my job done. Yes, we've all learned that in 2020, the most outstanding human quality still is our collective ability to adapt. But what comes next? What can we expect for the workplace of the future? Let's check it out. This is GMF Compact. A survey by Gartner HR revealed that nearly half of all employees will be expected to work remotely at least part of their time after COVID-19 is over. Some companies will even pay bonuses for you to never come into the office again, because that means they can get rid of the office, which usually is one of the highest overheads in any organization. In other words, you might be able to work from anywhere. That same analysis also found that this shift will go hand in hand with more autonomy, both as a direct consequence of the rise in remote working, but also out of a growing demand among remote employees. Delivering on agreed goals will matter a lot more than how you deliver. And this is a huge change from the 9-to-5 mindset we've been used to. Sounds great? Not so fast. Companies are also predicted to use more electronic monitoring methods in the future to check in on your progress. They will still know when you work, how you work, when you perform your best, and when you might be distracted. And this raises obvious concerns about data issues. And for those of us who do still have to return to an office building, there'll be flexibility there too. But this might mean that you could lose that corner office of yours to allow for more hot desking and flexible workspace arrangements. And this is where we have to talk about age. Older generations might have a hard time adjusting to all this change, whilst millennials will fare better and will welcome the flexibility, according to research. And a whole new industry will rise up around working remotely. Do you need residency papers or work permit if you're not registered in a country? Where do you pay your taxes? And how will healthcare look in this globalized, digitized economy? Regardless of technology and transformation processes, the biggest single change in years to come will be the takeover of leadership positions of Generation Z, roughly those born around the turn of the century. What leadership styles will emerge as the young ones rise up the ranks? Only time will tell.